I would, but my damn mind won't let me. A Teen's Guide to Controlling Their Thoughts and Feelings, Book 2 of 3 from the Words of Wisdom for Teen series, written by Jacqui Letran, narrated by Melanie Hensch. Chapter 1. Why Can't You Just Control Yourself? How many times have you been told by well-meaning parents, adults, or even your friends that you should just stop thinking or feeling a certain way? They tell you that the problems you have are all in your head. They tell you to stop making a big deal out of things, that you're too sensitive, and there is no reason to be nervous or anxious. And yet, you are. You don't know what to think or how to feel. You feel tense and nervous. Others seem to have it so easy. But for you, life is difficult and so unfair. Your situation may seem hopeless. Perhaps you have even concluded that you were just born that way, and there is nothing you can do to change. But what if you are wrong about that conclusion? What if there was a way for you to create the changes you desperately desire? What if you can be taught how to take control of your mind, thoughts, and feelings? Would you want to learn how to do that for yourself? You see, the power of the human mind is incredible. It is capable of creating horrible life experiences, and it is capable of creating happy, successful ones, too. It might not feel that way right now, but you do get to choose which life experiences you'll have. Once you learn easy yet highly effective ways to take charge of your mind, you'll find that you have the power to create the life you want and deserve. The power to create permanent, positive change is available to you, no matter what you are currently struggling with. So, stop wasting your energy and time on those old, useless emotions and thoughts. Today is the day to change your life experiences. This book will show you how to challenge your old negative belief patterns, stop unhealthy thoughts and feelings, create positive life experiences for yourself, stay calm and in control in any situation, unleash the power of your mind to create the life you want and deserve. Everyone's journey to happiness begins with the belief that happiness is possible. Even if your personal experiences have led you to believe you are destined to have a difficult life filled with stress, anxiety, and unhappiness, I'm going to show you that you do have other options. You can learn to believe that happiness is possible for you. In this book, I will show you how to take charge of your mind to overcome your obstacles and struggles. I will show you simple yet powerful principles to strengthen your self-belief that leads to a solid foundation for happiness and success. So the next time somebody asks you, "Why can't you just control yourself?" you can smile and thank them for the gentle reminder and instantly take control of your thoughts and feelings again. You are the key to your success and happiness. Now, close your eyes and imagine for a moment how wonderful your life will be once you fully understand how to control your thoughts, feelings, and actions. If you are ready to make that dream life your reality, I encourage you to listen to this book with an open mind and a willingness to try something new. Get ready to be amazed at how quickly you can take charge of your life now. 60-second summary. Number 1. You get to choose which life experiences you'll have. Number 2. You have the power to create the life you want and deserve. Number 3. The power to create permanent, positive change is available to you, no matter what you are struggling with currently. Number 4. You can learn to A. Challenge your old negative belief patterns. B. Stop unhealthy thoughts and feelings. C. Create positive life experiences for yourself. D. Stay calm and in control in any situation. E. Unleash the power of your mind to create the life you want and deserve. Number 5. You can learn to be happy. Self-reflection. Take 5 minutes to think about how your life will be once you can stop those negative thoughts from occurring and instead focus on the positives of every situation. What would that look like? What would you do? How would your life be different? Go ahead and use your imagination and have fun with this self-reflection. Write down all the wonderful things you'll finally be able to do. Remember to dream big. Chapter 2. Your conscious versus your subconscious mind. To take control of your mind, it is important to understand the differences between the conscious and the subconscious mind, and the roles that each part of your mind plays in your life. Your conscious mind. The conscious part of your mind is your logical self. It is capable of seeing the past, present, and future. It solves problems and stores your goals and dreams. It has free will to reject or accept concepts and ideas. There are 3 main things to know and remember about your conscious mind. Number 1. It is responsible for logic, reasoning, and decision-making. Number 2. It controls all of your intentional actions. Number 3. It acts as a filtering system, rejecting or accepting information. What does this really mean? The conscious part of your mind is the part that you are aware of. It's the part of your mind that you use when you are learning a new concept. For example, it helps you to learn how to ride a bike. When you are in the learning phase, you are consciously focused on how to balance yourself, how to pedal, how to move forward without crashing into something or losing your balance. All those thoughts and actions are the work of your conscious mind, something you are fully aware of. Your conscious mind is also responsible for collecting data, processing the data, and making decisions based on the data at hand. It is the part of your mind that makes simple decisions such as, I want to wear that black sweater because it looks good with my jeans. It also makes more complicated decisions, such as what college you choose to apply to based on the career path you desire. While your conscious mind is quite amazing in its ability to collect, process, and make sense of the data, it has its limitations. Did you know that your conscious mind can only process less than 1% of all the data available to you at any given moment? At any given time, you can only consciously focus on less than 1% of all the things that are going on within yourself and your environment. Even if you were to be able to process 10 times this amount, you would still be missing 90% of the facts and data available to you. That's a pretty incomplete picture if you ask me. Knowing that now should cause you to ask some questions about your life experiences so far. What have I been missing? What information did I not even detect? How would my life be different if I have access to different information? Later, I will explain this concept further and show you how to use this knowledge to take control of your thoughts and actions so you can take control of your life. Before we dive into that, let's talk about your subconscious mind and its functions. Your subconscious mind. Your subconscious mind reacts based on instincts, habits, and learning from past experiences that are programmed into what I call the master plan. The master plan is a detailed set of instructions, like a movie script, that tells your subconscious mind what to do. Your subconscious mind does not have free will. Any ideas, thoughts, or feelings that get into the subconscious part of your mind stay there. There are 5 main things to know and remember about your subconscious mind. Number 1. It is responsible for all of your involuntary actions, breathing, heartbeat, etc. Number 2. It is 100% automatic and follows scripts. It has no ideas and thoughts of its own. Number 3. It stores all of your memories, life experiences, learned information, and beliefs. Number 4. Its main function is to keep you alive and safe. Number 5. Your subconscious mind processes information through pictures and images, or what we call an internal representation, or IR for short.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.